So Cozi, first of all, congratulations.
Thank you. We're back.
Yes. Have you seen the movie?
Yes.
Okay. How many times at this point?
4.
Okay. And is it weird watching yourself?
Yes. I'm just going to give you one word answers this whole time.
Yes.
No, it's very weird, especially like playing a 40-year-old woman, like a wife and a mom. That was definitely different to watch myself do that.
Of course. And your just on-screen relationship with Heidi, just, it's so genuine on screen.
And off screen.
And off screen. So, like, were you guys kind of just thrown into it as mother and daughter, or did you guys spend a lot of time before filming together?
You know, it's a little bit of both. When we screen tested, we met each other for 5 minutes and then we're thrown into
like,
auditioning with each other, singing the huge, I mean, spoiler alert, we do switch back. Oh my gosh.
No way.
But the song where we do that is very emotional and we just sang it together in the room full of like 15 Disney executives. It was so stressful, but it literally, they put together a little package where you watch our screen test and the TV version almost side by side, and it looks almost exactly the same because we just clicked so immediately.
That's proof that you just, it was meant to be.
Yeah.
Amazing. And that scene where you guys actually switch bodies in your, in Ellie's bedroom.
Yeah.
It's so powerful. Did that take a lot of practice, or did you guys kind of get to just feel it out and?
I mean, you know, it took a lot of conversation beforehand. We talked, we didn't rehearse that scene a lot.
Mm-hmm.
In movies, you barely rehearse. It's more like just coming in, knowing your lines, and then being spontaneous in the moment. But yeah, just talking and getting to know each other so well and learning mannerisms from each other. And so that when you see the switch, it's very obvious was the hope.
Did you find yourself kind of acting like a mother figure off camera?
I'm already kind of like a, I don't know if I'm such a dork that I wouldn't necessarily say I'm a mama bear, but actually Jennifer Laporte, who plays one of my best friends, Monica, she was Mama Jen. But I really do care about making sure everybody's okay and happy. And it was really actually cool in this movie because for the first time I was a leading player, like, you know, kind of like one of the two main leading players. And with that comes a huge responsibility and honor to set the tone on set. You know, if you're unhappy and you're a diva, then the whole set is kind of like, oh, okay, oh gosh. But if you're happy and welcoming and supportive, then it allows everybody to take a deep breath, and it was really special to purpose to do that.
Yeah, and it seemed like the cast had such an amazing dynamic on set. Do you guys ever hang out off set too?
Oh yeah, we've got a freaky group chat. Yeah, we do, but
love
you
that.
Know, it's actually really sad because a lot of the kids in the movie my age are from Vancouver, so
aww.
I miss them a lot, and we're all here today, and that's been awesome.
Yeah, you'll have to have some reunions.
Yeah, oh yeah.
So what was the most challenging dance number to film, or to learn even, because it seemed like a lot went into that.
At Last It's Me, the last one.
Yes.
That was definitely a challenge. John Carafa is so patient with me, and he really brought out all my strengths, that's for sure, because, he helped me so much come into my own dance-wise. It was the thing, out of all the things I do in the movie, it was the thing I had the least background of, and so it was really special to spread my wings in that way.
Amazing. Were there any funny kind of blooper moments in the process of filming these very intricate dance numbers?
You know what? Less of the dance, you know, okay, so in Go, the scavenger hunt scene, there's a lot of time where I run with the hourglass. I broke so many of those, so many.
So there was more than one, we should
there
know.
There had to be, literally because of me. But there were only a few glass ones, and then there were a lot of plastic ones, just because I would break them so often.
Yeah, that's
amazing. And I wasn't trying to.
You weren't trying to.
Yeah. One time I actually ran so hard, I hit myself in the face with it, and I had a fat lip.
Oh no.
Only for like 20 minutes. We put ice on it, and then it was like, good, I'm good to go.
Back to normal.
Yeah.
That's amazing. So what has the fan reaction been like? You've shown the movie to so many kids so far, and it hasn't even come out for real yet. So you've gotten a taste. What's it like?
It's very overwhelming. At our premiere, which was last night actually, but the movie still hasn't come out.
Yes.
TV's funny that way. the whole Broadway community showed up to watch, and that was so overwhelming because I'm the biggest musical theater fan ever, and to have people I look up to so much enjoy the movie and compliment our performances, I left my body. I was just so overwhelmed with gratitude and excitement.
That's amazing. And, you know, being a part of the Disney Channel family, I know you're no stranger to Disney Channel. You've been in many other shows. Have you kind of helped bring in the newbies into the family, give them advice, maybe?
Well, actually, it's been really cool because in some ways, yes, I'm kind of a Disney veteran, you know, in all their shows. But in other ways, I'm super new to starring in one of their DCOMs. It's a whole nother beautiful world. And so actually the kids from Zombies, the previous DCOM, have been so amazing. They're the most supportive, sweet people in the whole world. And so I'm looking forward to doing that for the cast of Kim Possible You know, the new DCOMs coming out. But also, the other players in the movie with me, they're really excited to be part of that too. It's a special journey for all of us.
Amazing. Well, I can't wait for everyone to see the movie.
Thank you.